Hey YouTube, this is Stefano. I wanted to go over this Echo GT225, one that I had basically garbage picked and had to do some repairs to. And the main repair that I want to talk about today, which was my fault that I didn't catch, because I'm not a professional repairman or anything. I like to repair stuff like this. I had never messed around with these particular Zama carbs and this type of throttle body system. And I had watched some videos before, very helpful, and did not pay attention to this because I was in a hurry to get some things back together. But as you see here, those of you who know this is Zama Carb, or you're just learning about it, this throttle body fits in here, and it's a rotating throttle body that lifts the pin out of the jet to let more fuel in. And how it lifts as it turns is the roller that's supposed to be in that little pin right there. And what I had done in some other repairs, or just messing with the carb, I took it out and I had the roller. I was putting the roller back in, and just in the course of putting it back in, it just kind of slipped, and it's currently under my feet somewhere here in my garage. But anyhow, what was going on with it without the roller in there? It was running fine at first until this throttle body started wearing out, and I developed a flat spot in running it. I could get it to idle. It would go up to a high speed okay if the high jet screw was adjusted right, and I couldn't figure out how in the world a flat spot could be in there. And then after a couple of days or just chewing on it, I forgot that this roller was out. So without the roller, this was not lifting, especially through the mid acceleration, and it wasn't lifting this. So I had purchased this block on eBay, or purchased an off brand, not a Zama carb, purchased this with everything intact on it. So I had put this whole new carb on the Echo, and it didn't work. So what I did, I took all the parts off of this block, and I didn't really knock the guy on it for this block not working, because I ended up using all the parts off of it anyway. And I was able to just use all the everything out of this and get a brand new carb kit out of a $15 knockoff carb block. But anyhow, when I ended up putting that old roller, putting the roller back in the carb on the other one that's actually on here now, it worked perfect. So the only reason I'm posting this video is to just warn you, as a couple other videos did that helped me out, is to make sure that that roller gets put in there. I knew it was supposed to be in there, but I left it out because I was in a hurry. I just wanted to see if it was running okay, and I forgot that it was left out. And so it has to be in there. If it's not, it will work fine okay, but then it'll start scoring that ramp. And what will happen is this edger ages as well, especially as people are buying these at Home Depot and everywhere else. We're probably going to find a lot of these on the curb, because I think these throttle bodies might wear out, and people are going to get, you know, tired of messing with them or whatever. And plus, not knowing where the high jet screw is on, or the high idle is on this, because it's hidden. Those of you know that it's hidden behind the little brass insert with a black plug, and that jet screw is out there. So basically, again, this video is about the roller. Make sure that it's in there if you're going to work on it. And if it gets that far to where this throttle body is messed up or worn out, you just need to buy a new $35 or $40 Zama carb to stick on this thing, and not really mess with it. And also too, if it has been sitting around for a while, you do need to dig that jet out of there. And the way that I got mine readjusted, didn't really find any videos on how to exactly adjust it, except for maybe one. I seated mine all the way back in, maybe did a half or one full turn back out, and then cranked it and put it on high idle on basically just wide open, and then began to adjust the screw till I found it where the spot needs to be. So as you increase this out, or you increase the turns out, the idle will go down, so you need to adjust your idle once you adjust the screw. So, but that's not the main purpose of the video. Again, I just want to help those that are going to start working on this carb or never messed with it before. Do not drop that roller, especially if you've got, have no other extra parts to mess with it. So this really should probably never come out anyway, unless somehow the carb has been gooped up and you just want to clean or lubricate something and blow it out. But protect that roller and make sure it gets back in there. So I hope this video helped somebody. As a couple other videos, I believe 805 Road King helps out a lot, especially on how to tune this GT225 to get the carb set up right, how to get the plug out. He's got a great video on that. So have a great day. Hope this helps you out.